Young brothers and sisters you got who do this, we got enough young folks to replace y'all, so why y'all ain't passed the baton yet? Because the white man has castrated you so much that you need every opportunity for glamour and prestige that accrues to you. Look at what the white man do. Soon he start getting old, he put a young buck in there. He helps him, but he ain't out front no more, nor does he have a desire to be. Not us. We gonna die with our boots on. We have a problem with that. Our whole movement is being dictated by senior citizens. That's not healthy. You know why? Because naturally, when you get older, you grow conservative. Naturally, you do that. Because you in your golden years, and you want to enjoy some of that. You don't want to be going to jail at 80. You don't want to be going to court at 75. That's a young man's thing. So when you are an 85-year-old leader, you're going to take certain... Nelson Mandela. Why you think they was able to do that to him? Because he was old. He'd been in jail 27 years. The man was old. He was ready to take a break. And so they was able to co-opt him. The Mandela that came out of jail wasn't the one who went in. And we will always honor the one who went in, because the one who went in is a hero of mine. The one who came out ain't. But I understand old age does that to you. And we got to recognize that and pass that damn baton before it's too late. That's a discussion that we are not having. That's a discussion. You will never get nowhere when all your leaders are the senior citizens. Why you thinking ain't no young black men in the church? You do not see corner boys in the church. For several reasons. One of them being there's no opportunity to lead. The pastor there, he already got his bishops in place. And all you can do is come and sing. And pay you money. You see? So my point is, brothers and sisters, we got a lot of contradictions amongst us that we not dealing with. The whole African history thing. I'm tired of it. Y'all want to keep teaching African history, but don't none of y'all build nothing. Right. All these scholars we got, they ain't built nothing. All they gave us was books, book after book, book after book. Making money. That's not struggle. When are you going to build something? But they get away with it. Because African scholars have gotten the same, the same freedom from criticism as the religious leaders do. You're not allowed to question the fact that you've been doing this for 30 years, but you haven't done nothing for the people yet but give a speech and write a book. That's not good enough for me now. I don't care how many books you wrote. I don't care how many papers you wrote. I don't care how many theories you came up with. I don't care how many degrees in the back of your name. What have you built for the community?
There you go.
I'm just sick and tired of people who talk black, live white, and think green. I'm tired of it. We've been going through it too long. We need a paradigm shift. That's why our children are rebelling in the streets, because they can see that all this shit is phony. They see it. They say, I go to church. I got to keep hearing about how great life's going to be after I die. I go to the black Afrocentric lecture. All I'm going to hear about is how great I was before I was born. I go to church, I got to live in the future. I go to the Afrocentric lecture, he would have talked about what happened in Egypt 5,000 years ago for 5 hours. I don't want to hear that shit. I need a job. My mother is homeless. My little brother got terminal cancer. You see what I'm saying? My sister pregnant. He's not giving me no solution for that, and he's not giving me one either. He wants to worship history, and he wants to worship death. I don't need either one of them. We are not relevant to our children, and that's why they're not paying us no money. People ask me all the time, why are you? Why are you the most requested lecturer? Which I've been for the past 3 years. Because I try to be relevant. Let's deal with the problems now. What's the use of coming to Oakland to give you a 3-hour lecture about ancient African history? All you got to do is read Dr. Ben for that. You don't need me here for that. We done already wrote them books. You don't need a lecturer to come and give you that. You can read that for yourself. But that's what they keep coming. Feel good history. It ain't nothing but church. It's church. And y'all